We're facing an unprecedented challenge with the global outbreak of the coronavirus disease. And in these uncertain times, while IASC members are balancing the well-being of their staff, we are still working and prioritising support to the most vulnerable people whom we're all here to serve and who need us now more than ever.
The COVID-19 pandemic is changing our lives, yet it does not stop wars, persecution, disasters. International solidarity, now more than ever, is needed to respond to the health emergency and also to sustain existing humanitarian programs.
We all know the virus doesn't discriminate, but its impact on most vulnerable people is highly discriminatory. It impacts the ones left behind in a highly disproportionate manner. Let's make sure that we include the needs of this vulnerable population in our programming and response. While we practice physical distancing to break the chain of transmission, it's extremely important to strengthen the social solidarity and support. The psychological impact of distancing could be massive. Let's find new ways of virtual social bonding. Let's call each other to listen and to be there to support.
At the core of our work and the focus of our response are always the most vulnerable and marginalized communities. Refugees, people living in conflict areas, those requiring protection, the disabled, the disenfranchised, different minorities. We work together with others in solidarity to make sure that all are included in the response of the international community as we work together to combat this difficult disease.
IASC partners have developed critical interim guidance on the coronavirus to support readiness and response in camps and to address mental health and psychosocial support, all available on the IASC website. Stay tuned for upcoming guidance on food distribution, prevention and control in schools and in prisons. Together, we can ensure humanitarian assistance gets to the people who now need it more than ever.